So the gentlemen, welcome to the first industry showcase presented by IEML, India Expo Mart Limited, in our series of webinars, which we are calling the IHE 2020 webinar series. You'll hear more about the series from Mr. Anil Mansharamani, who a lot of you must be knowing. He's a director on the board of IEML. He's the managing director of Vectra. That's the name of his company. He's also an IITian and very well known in the IITian circles. Without much ado, I welcome Mr. Mansharamani and invite him to deliver the welcome address so that we can get the ball rolling. Mr. Mansharamani.
Thank you, Mr. Bhattavari. Only thing is that instead of an IITian, I'm a Bitsian. I'm from
Bitsian. Okay.
Anyway, thank you very much.
Same league of excellence. It's okay.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody. Esteemed panelists, friends of the IHE 2020, and members of the audience who have come to this forum from different cities in India and countries around the world. In the 11 webinars that India Expo Mart Limited has hosted over the past 6 weeks, we have focused on how the hospitality sector and the industries that draw their sustenance from it should respond to the post-COVID-19 challenge of implementing the new physical distancing and stringent sanitary norms. Our webinars have thrown up dozens of actionable ideas, and our panelists have worked overtime to answer the scores of questions from our audience. Indeed, the platform has brought together domain experts and decision makers from the hotel, restaurant, events, banqueting, sweets and namkeens, bakery, confectionery, furniture and furnishings, and hospitality equipment verticals. We've had the who's who of the affected industries speak up on issues related to the implementation of the new protocols and the likely speed breakers. Our speakers have included hotel industry leaders such as Mr. K.B. Kachru, Mr. Anil Bhandari, Mr. Dilip Puri, Mr. Ratan Keswani, and Mr. Vijay Devan, top restaurateurs such as Zohawar Kalra, A.D. Singh, Ritu Dalmia, Riaz Amlani, Priyanka Sukheja, and Jungdup Lama. One of the country's foremost mall operators, Pushpa Bector, India's best known event manager, Sabas Joseph of Wisgraf, leading caterers such as Sanjay Kullar and Puneet Sikand, apart from leaders of industry bodies such as Anurag Katyar of NRAI, Chief Chef Davinder Kumar of the Indian Culinary Forum, Chef Manjeet Singh Gill of the Indian Federation of Culinary Association, Feroz Naqvi of the Federation of Sweets and Namkeen Manufacturers of India, Amarjeet Ahuja of PPFI, Nitin Nagrale of HPMF, Jayashri Nagraj of the Professional Housekeepers Association, Ramesh Dang of the Delhi Banquet Federation, Anil Malhotra and Nirmal Khandelwal of Patumai, Rajat Pandey of Archie, and Hemant Sood of IDDD. They have all been our allies and have worked together with us to make the India International Hospitality Expo at the IML Greater Noida India's best hospitality sector trade show. Our discussions have been lively and engaging, and our audiences have been flooding us with questions on average, more than 50 per webinar, showing that the level of interest in our choice of topics and our panelists had to say. From the discussions, we've learned that many of the engineering and design solutions are already available with our resourceful friends on the manufacturing end of the hospitality business. We have therefore invited representatives of 12 engineering and furniture and furnishing firms to showcase products relevant to the implementation of the post-COVID-19 physical distancing and sanitary norms. From discussions, we are moving on to action, and we all excitedly look forward to the first of the two virtual showcases planned and executed by the IML team. It was with immense pleasure that I invite the following 12 gentlemen who promised to pack our inaugural showcase and ideas and innovation. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Rajesh Kumar, Managing Director, Equipment India Private Limited, Mr. Girish Chandra, Country Head and Sales and Marketing, Venus, Mr. Naman Dadu, owner Dadu Ceramic Group, Mr. Shivan Khanna of I2I Consulting, who will represent the USA Poultry and Egg Export Council, India, Mr. Vinay Mittal, Director, Dipali Designs and Exhibits Private Limited, Mr. Michael Benedict, Division Manager Projects, Williams Refrigeration, Mr. Mohit Agarwal, Sales Director, South Asia, Warwick Fabrics, Mr. Madan Gopal Mishra, Manager, KIA Group, Mr. Rajiv Bhatnagar, Managing Director, Multi Seeds Private Limited, Mr. Jatin Gut, Director, Radhakrishnan and Sons, Mr. Harish Lulani, Director, Sumitra International, Mr. Abhinav Arya, Director, Planning, Febcare, Garments and Textile Air. I am sure that the audience who are drawn from across India and around the world is eager here to them, their presentations as we are. We hope this will be our way of talking the discussion on the fallout of the COVID-19 pandemic, an important step forward, from discussions to solutions, from the thought to action. We seem to have embarked on an exciting new journey. I would not like to come in between the audience and the panelists, so I would like our moderator, Mr. Suresh Bhattacharya, to take charge and go ahead and start the webinar. Thank you. Mr. Bhattacharya, you have to unmute yourself. Mr. Bhattacharya, you are muted.
I've unmuted myself. Mr. Manshramani, thank you so much for your words to set the whole industry showcase in perspective. We have actually arranged.
I made a mistake like Rakesh Kumar last time. It's Priyank and not Priyanka, which I again made a mistake.
Yeah. Priyank, I think, has got used to being called Priyanka on this forum. You know? So, yes, that's right. We will, the list of presentations has been just organized at random by us through draw of lots. And we invite Mr. Rajesh Kumar, Managing Director, Kumar Equipment India Private Limited, to set the ball rolling. Mr. Kumar, please note that you have between 4.5 to 5 minutes. Please try to stick to the time limit. Thank you so much and all the best.
Good morning, everybody. I hope everybody is fine and safe at home. Due to this pandemic, COVID-19, we are very tense in further business and especially in hospital industry. But now we, as a manufacturer, we have responsibilities. Maybe we are thinking of alternate importing equipment, and especially what we are taking a step of as per the situations. So we are developing many equipment that of future. Imported to an Indian equipment. Yeah. And especially we are developing a few equipment of sanitizer chambers and a sanitizing machine. And after dishwashing with the sanitizing dryer with the UV lights. So we are thinking for new developing as per current scenario. Sir.
Yes. A little bit about the UV lights, there is a lot of concern about how safe UV is, or how safe UV rays are. Have you looked into this issue at all?
Yeah, we are thinking many point, but I think UV lights, especially if we are focusing directly for any food and any body, this is little harmful. But especially for like cutlery and some plates and dining plates and some only for utensils, I think this is not harmful. This is very useful for drying and form of all germs.
So as long as human contact is minimal, UV rays are
99% not touch any human. Yeah,
right. Yes. Interesting. Good. That's a nice caveat to give. So I guess in a banqueting situation, if you have plates kept in a UV light chamber or in a chamber with UV rays, will there be a little greater like a reassurance in the minds of guests that they're having something safe?
Yes, sir. We are focusing, definitely we are focusing all safety norms. But even 99%, we are very sure that this is not harmful any as a human and very safe for using all cutlery and utensil. This is very safe.
Right. Trust me. As a first line of defense against COVID, I think this is something very useful that you've come up with. Any other product that you would like to talk about?
Yes, Mr. Bhattacharya, because as per our Prime Minister, he also very worried for, I think one word, local oblique vocal, but just like in second word is Atmanirbhar. So, we have developed a lot of equipment, especially jitna bhi imported equipment. I am not against of imported equipment, but we are very worried of our local manufacturing. तो उसको लेकर हम लोगों ने काफी सारे डेवलपिंग किया ऑलरेडी लास्ट अराउंड 4 to 5 years से हम लोग इंपोर्टेड इक्विपमेंट का काफी अल्टरनेट करते हुए आ रहे हैं लेकिन इस बार हम स्पेशली लाइक इंडक्शन इक्विपमेंट वी आर वेरी फोकस्ड इन फर्दर इंडस्ट्री फॉर इंडक्शन इक्विपमेंट्स
तो आप ये इंडक्शन यहां बना रहे हैं हिंदुस्तान में
हम लोग इधर बना रहे हैं बिकॉज नॉर्मली इंडक्शन के जो कंपोनेंट्स हैं वो अभी तक टोटली डिपेंड ऑन चाइना कोरिया एंड अदर कंट्री
जी जी जी
लेकिन हम लोगों ने उसका अभी इंडियन वर्जन अभी वी आर वेरी सक्सेसफुल नॉट फॉर ऑल अदर मार्केट बट जो ट्रायल हम लोगों के हुए हैं अभी लास्ट 1.5 years के अंदर
जी
तो वो वी आर हम लोग अभी तक संतुष्ट हैं उस चीज को लेकर बाकी डिपेंड करेगा कस्टमर के जो फीडबैक आएंगे या जो और बाकी हमारे पार्टनर के फीडबैक आएंगे
जी
लेकिन उसका इवन उसका कॉइलिंग सिस्टम उसका आईसी सिस्टम उसका जितना भी इलेक्ट्रिकल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक जो जितना भी कंपोनेंट्स है वो सभी को यहाँ की जो इंडियन रेपुटेटेड जो कंपनी लाइक L&T लाइक अदर कंपनी भी सभी के साथ हम लोग और एक्सचेंज कर रहे हैं अभी
जी जी
और उसके अंदर हम लोगों ने अभी तक काफी हद तक सफलता हासिल की है इवन उसका सक्सेस रेशो काफी रहा है
जी.
और 1.5 years आई थिंक काफी लॉन्ग टाइम होता है एक ट्रायल के लिए और टेस्ट के लिए
जी.
तो ये हम लोगों का एक अचीवमेंट है अभी कि हमने कॉमर्शियल इंडक्शन टोटली उसको एज 100% इंडियन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग को डेवलप किया है
जी
दूसरा
तो दैट्स अ वेरी गुड ये तो बहुत ही बढ़िया बढ़िया बात है ना और ये जब अगर हम गो वोकल अबाउट लोकल की बात करते हैं तो ये इसके बारे में हमें और ज्यादा बात करना चाहिए पर सर आपका टाइम खत्म हो गया 5 minutes खत्म हो गए हैं सो वी विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट प्रेजेंटर So, we heard Mr. Rajesh Kumar talk about two things, UV containers for plates and cutlery, and induction ranges with almost 100% indigenous parts, which is a very good thing. There's less dependence on China and Korea. Our next speaker is going to be Mr. Girish Chandra, who's the country head sales and marketing for Venus. Mr. Chandra.
Hi. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah. Very good morning, everyone.
Hanji, boli. Where are you? Okay, now you're connected. Yes, that's right.
Right. Yeah, good morning.
Sir, aapka mood puri tarah se dikh nahi raha hai. Aapko thoda sa, I think.
It's okay, sir?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's absolutely fine. You You're wearing your face mask, as I can see.
Okay.
Chaliye ji. Yeah,
first of all, would like to thank IHE for giving Venus Industries this platform to project its product line and innovation during this COVID period. Yeah, Venus Industries, as you all know, is one of the established names in the field of manufacturing classy, luxurious designers, stainless steel hotelwares products like cutlery, barware items, chef and dishes, and many more ranges.
Right.
Yeah, we have been serving the hospitality industry from past 57 years and have created a niche in international and domestic market.
Now, where are you based? In Delhi?
In Delhi. We are office in Delhi and manufacturing in our Sonipat, sir.
Ji.
And last year, only in 2019, Venus Industry launched a co-brand, namely VS6, not only happened to be an economic brand, but at the same time to serve the mass requirement.
Right.
Yeah, we have launched very innovative range of economic chef and dishes, snack warmers, cutlery patterns under this brand.
Right.
And there shall be many more innovation to see once the lockdown and what the business goes, sir.
Now, talking about COVID-19 specifically, are you developing any line of products?
Which are
sort of compliant with the new sanitary requirements.
Just give me, I just show you the one of our product. Yeah, during this this COVID period and lockdown, we have introduced new product range of hand-free hand wash system.
Right.
Yeah. Hand-free sanitizer system, stainless steel trolleys, which is very useful in hotels. And some more innovation is already in production to tackle this need to present the COVID-19 scenario.
Talking about stainless steel trolleys, how are they? How will they prevent something like COVID-19 from spreading?
If you see, when the customer come in hotel,
yes,
they prefer they carry their luggage self, sir. No anyone touch the bird. So we are making us a small trolleys.
Right. Okay.
Yeah, the hotel staff is not able to touch this. I share some photo if you see, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everyone is able to see my screen, sir. Hello.
I cannot see it, sir. But if the rest of the team can, we can. Yes, we can see. Yes.
Yeah. You see this picture, sir?
Yeah.
So we can see the folder and not the picture. Share the screen with the picture.
Share the screen with picture.
Do a share screen.
Yeah, new share.
If you could open the picture first and then share the screen, that would solve the purpose.
Okay. Yeah.
Sir, please stop share. The option click on.
Yes,
stop share. And now on the screen share, just share the picture directly, not the folder.
Okay. Just
Aman.
Yeah, it's okay.
Okay, now it's clear, absolutely.
Yeah, this is a totally a hand-free hand wash system, sir.
Okay.
Yeah, if you see, there is a foot press at the bottom of this machine.
That's right.
Yeah, there's a soap dispenser is there and the tap is there.
And enough hand wash to last a shift at least, you know? So what is the capacity of this?
The water tank, 100 liters.
Okay.
Yeah, that's, we can give you a small one if you need a big one. Also, we can give you 200 liters.
Okay, fantastic. So this is really interesting, and you rightly said protect yourself against the coronavirus, So thank you. Thanks, Mr. Chandra. I think that was something exciting and different. So we'll now move on to Mr. Naman Dadu. Is he here? Yes, do I see him?
Yes, sorry. Sir.
Yeah, I can. Ah, but I can see you now. Okay. Yeah, so please start. So what's new and exciting at your end?
Yes, sir. Sir, pehle sabko namaskar.
Namaskar ji.
Thank you to IHE. Thank you for the opportunity aapne sabne diya. Aur hum sabse aaj is tense mahol mein sabse baat kar pa rahe hain. To main aaj apne factory ke display showroom mein hi baitha hu taki hum log background mein dekh sake hum log crockery manufacture karte hain. जैसा मोदी जी ने बोला है सबको मैन्युफैक्चरर्स को इंस्पिरेशन मिली है कि भी हम लोकल इंडियन प्रोडक्ट बनाएं और इसको इंडिया में ही कंज्यूम कर लें और इसी थिंकिंग से हम लोग 40 साल से काम करते आ रहे हैं. मैं हूँ, मेरे फादर हैं, हमारे ताऊजी हैं, हम लोग मिलकर काम करते हैं सब. एंड सर क्रॉकरी हम लोग बना रहे हैं, होटल रेस्टोरेंट्स में सप्लाई हो रही है, अच्छा है. बट थोड़ा सा आजकल सिचुएशन थोड़ी टेंस्ड है, तो वी आर होपिंग कि सब कुछ ठीक जल्दी हो जाएगा. एंड वी आर ऑलरेडी एक्सपोर्टिंग द प्रोडक्ट्स आल्सो. तो मैं कुछ एक प्रेजेंटेशन शेयर करना चाहूंगा, पहले शायद सब लोग देख पाए इसको. मैं स्क्रीन शेयर करता हूं अपनी.
आपकी एक्सपोर्ट बिजनेस से शुरू हो गई है, यू हैव रिज्यूमड इट?
यस सर.
एंड वी कैन सी इट. या
सर, दिस इज द छोटी प्रेजेंटेशन है जो मैं सबको बताना चाहूंगा. आई थिंक सब देख पा रहे होंगे इस प्रेजेंटेशन को.
जी
सर, डिनर प्लेट्स, क्वार्टर प्लेट्स से स्टार्ट होता है होटल वेयर. एंड एक हमारी जो एक रेंज है मैट फिनिश में हम लोग बनाते हैं सब. हम इसे बोलते हैं नेचुरल मैट फिनिश. सो इस सीरीज ने काफी होटल वेयर में बोनचारा पोर्सलिन क्रॉकरी को रिप्लेस किया है. और पिछले कई सालों से बड़ा अच्छा रिस्पांस हमें मिल रहा है इसमें. एंड उसके बाद डिफरेंट तरह के प्लेटर्स होते हैं, सर्विंग बाउल्स होते हैं फॉर सैलेड्स एंड पास्तास. कुछ लोग ब्रांडिंग भी कराते हैं अपनी अपने आगे एज अ सुवेनियर और आगे अपने ब्रांड को स्ट्रॉन्ग करने के लिए. लाइक कुछ अच्छे बड़े होटल के ग्रुप्स हैं जो हमसे ब्रांडिंग भी करवाते हैं क्रॉकरी के ऊपर. कुछ कलर ऑप्शंस पे हम लोग आगे डील करते हैं, जैसा कस्टमर कहता है वैसे हम लोग चीजें कस्टमाइज कर देते हैं. आजकल लोग काफी ट्रेंड में हैं आजकल कलर्ड क्रॉकरी. तो कुछ स्टूडियो पॉटरी इफेक्ट है, कुछ नॉर्मल कलर्स हैं ब्लैक, ग्रे, ब्लू, सम कलर्स लाइक ऑरेंज एंड सम हैंड पेंटिंग कॉन्सेप्ट जो कि हम अच्छा एक्सपोर्ट भी कर लेते हैं. यूरोप अमेरिका में लोग हैंड पेंटिंग बहुत प्रेफर करते हैं और इंडिया में भी बहुत अच्छी डिमांड है हैंड पेंटिंग स्टफ की. ये कुछ एक लुक है जो हमारे कस्टमर्स ऑलरेडी यूज कर रहे हैं क्रॉकरी. इस तरह से फूड डिस्प्ले होता है क्रॉकरी के ऊपर तो नेचुरली अच्छा लगता है कलर्ड वेयर के ऊपर. तो दीज आर सम फोटोज फ्रॉम आवर कस्टमर्स हु आर यूजिंग दिस कलर्ड क्रॉकरी वेयर.
जी तो इसमें से यू नो फॉर स्पेसिफिक आज हमारा जो यू नो जो टॉपिक है COVID-19 के खिलाफ कुछ कर उसके अगेंस्ट कुछ कर रहे हैं आप? उसके कुछ प्रॉपर्टी लाइन आपकी ऐसे हैं जो COVID-19 से लोगों को बचा सके या विच विल प्रिवेंट द स्प्रेड ऑफ COVID-19?
सर स्प्रेड के देखिए जहां तक हाइजीन का सवाल है, हाइजीनिक क्रॉकरी ऑलरेडी होती ही है.
हाँ हाँ,
लेड फ्री क्रॉकरी होती है, कैडमियम फ्री होता है, कंप्लीटली फूड सेफ. एंड रेस्टोरेंट्स में जितना सब लोग क्रॉकरी यूज करते हैं हाइजीनिकली सब लोग क्लीन करके रखते ही हैं, उतना अच्छा रहता है. बट अभी हम कोविड की बात कर रहे हैं, थोड़ा सा बिजनेस भी सभी लोग के इफेक्ट हुए हैं. तो मैं आपको इसी प्रेजेंटेशन के साथ साथ आपको एक नया प्रोडक्ट दिखाना चाहूंगा जस्ट लाइव. मुझे अपॉर्चुनिटी मिली है कि आज मैं सबके सामने एक प्रोडक्ट लॉन्च कर दूं. तो हमने टेराकोटा प्रोडक्ट लॉन्च किया है. आई एम जस्ट चेंजिंग माय व्यू नाउ लाइक दिस.
ओके,
I just sorry.
What is the material here?
Yeah. So this is all terracotta.
Yeah.
Terracotta products se sab log aware hai hi sab log. Uh-huh. Ki coolers bahut catering use karte hain aur choti choti plates bahut log use karte hain. Hum terracotta ki dinner plate taiyar kari hai. Which is 11 inches in diameter. और हम इस थिंकिंग से इस प्रोडक्ट को लॉन्च कर रहे हैं आज
right.
कि केटरर्स एंड होटेलियर्स को सबसे ज्यादा जरूरत पड़ेगी लोगों को गेस्ट को कंज्यूम हाइजीनिकली प्रूव करने के लिए कि हमारा खाना सेफ है. अभी भी बोनचारा या पोर्सेलेन सब अपनी जगह सेफ ही होता है बट इस टेराकोटा क्ले को हम कह सकते हैं विच इज वन टाइम यूज ऑर्गेनिक one-time consumable pottery जो कि आप एक बार इस्तेमाल करें और उसको यूज करने के बाद थ्रो कर दें. तो थ्रो करने के लिए भी कोई एनवायरमेंट में इसमें कोई हम गलत बात नहीं कर रहे हैं. प्लास्टिक और डिस्पोजेबल से तो बहुत अच्छा है कि हम अगर मिट्टी को यूज करके फेंकते हैं तो वो वापस मिट्टी में ही मिल जाती है. सो वी आर कमिंग आउट लाइक भारत की मिट्टी से भारत के हाथ से हम पॉटरी बना रहे हैं. एंड टेराकोटा पॉटरी जब लोग यूज करेंगे तो लोगों को पता चलेगा कि हाइजीनिक भी है और एक बार इस्तेमाल करके फेंक दी जाती है. और वी आर कमिंग आउट विद अ वेरी कॉम्पिटिटिव प्राइस. सिर्फ 40 रुपए की हम प्लेट लॉन्च कर रहे हैं 11 इंच की जो कि किसी भी होटल या रेस्टोरेंट में वो ज्यादा कॉस्ट फैक्टर नहीं लगेगा. आपने 40 रुपीज का एक प्लेट यूज किया और उसको कस्टमर को यूज करवा के उसको फेंक दिया तो उसमें होटल वाले को भी तो प्रॉब्लम नहीं होगी और कंज्यूमर को भी तो प्रॉब्लम नहीं होगी. सो ड्यू टू दिस कोविड एनवायरनमेंट बिजनेसेस को फर्क पड़ा है और लोगों को नई चीज सामने चाहिए थी तो हमने टेराकोटा की प्रोडक्ट लॉन्च करी है. आज हम इसमें बाउल्स ग्लासेस बॉटल्स बना सकते हैं. वाटर बॉटल का एक कॉन्सेप्ट नया नहीं है. इट्स अ वन ईयर ओल्ड कॉन्सेप्ट जो ऑलरेडी साउथ इंडिया से बॉटल बन रही है और यूज हो रही है. एंड एक हमने सर ये बड़ी थाली भी डिजाइन करी है जस्ट फॉर प्लेटिंग पर्पसेस इन रेस्टोरेंट्स. ये कुछ लाइंस ऐसी हैं जो हम ऑलरेडी सेरामिक पे बना रहे हैं तो हमने सोचा कि हम उसको टेराकोटा में लेकर आए. डिनर प्लेट का कॉन्सेप्ट नया है एंड जो प्राइसिंग है सर बहुत कॉम्पिटिटिव है. मतलब 5 रुपए का ग्लास 5 रुपए की कटोरी और आपकी 40 रुपए की प्लेट तो ये एक सेट में बनाएंगे तो 60-70 रुपए से ऊपर सेट हमारा कॉस्ट नहीं करता है. टैक्स फ्री आइटम होगा. टेराकोटा इज टैक्स फ्री फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. सो इसमें कोई टैक्सेस नहीं लगने. बस इसमें खर्चा आना है जो कि थोड़ा फ्रेट का आएगा रेस्टोरेंट तक पहुँचाने में. और आप इसको एक बार इस्तेमाल करिए उसको बाकी बाद में थ्रो कर दीजिए. तो जब भी कोई नया कस्टमर आएगा नया गेस्ट आएगा होटल रेस्टोरेंट में तो उसको हमेशा नई क्रॉकरी मिलेगी. वो किसी की इस्तेमाल करी हुई क्रॉकरी या धुली हुई क्रॉकरी नहीं होगी. तो आई थिंक
हेलो आपका टाइम खत्म हो गया नमन जी.
आई एम डन विद माय प्रेजेंटेशन आल्सो. थैंक यू सो मच
फॉर योर दिस. आई थिंक दिस विल इंप्रेस लॉट ऑफ होटेलियर्स हु आर लुकिंग फॉर ऑप्शंस फॉर डिस्पोजेबल क्रॉकरी. Thanks,
yes,
Terracotta crockery at very affordable rates. I think this is what the industry needs in a very big way.
Yes,
thank
sir.
You. Thank you, Mr. Dadu. Only we are sort of run, now we are running behind time, okay? Mr. Shivan Khanna.
Thank you, sorry.
Yeah, that's right. So, we are all aware about the scare that was caused over chickens at the beginning of the COVID pandemic. I hope you have been able to overcome that. And then there is always this little reservation about frozen foods generally. We all like to have our chickens fresh, you know. So what do you have to say to assuage people's feelings on both counts?
So, there was initial, there was some miscommunication on social media regarding consumption of chicken, which was later clarified by the Ministry of Animal Husbandry as well as FSSAI. So I think it has been clearly established that chicken has no relation with COVID, and now we've seen sales recuperate. Also, we feel that now frozen has really come to the forefront. You know, people want something hygienic, want something safe that they can store in their freezers. So we see the demand for frozen food pick up in the near future. So morning everyone. I'm Shivain Khanna. I work with the US Poultry and Egg Export Council. I hope everyone's keeping safe and healthy during these COVID times. So what has happened is that now US poultry is available in India. So we have, let me share my screen as well. I have a short presentation that I'd like to share with everyone. Can you see my screen?
Yes, I can.
Yeah. Oh, perfect. So, we have US chicken, US turkey, duck, and processed eggs that we are bringing to the Indian market. US has some of the highest standards of food safety in the world. So what we are offering is a high quality, safe, hygienic, and wholesome product that is an option for the consumer and the HRI industry. So as we discussed, the present scenario has given a rise to frozen options. Even a lot of restaurants and hotels have been approaching us when they open, they want to use frozen poultry. As you may be aware that US poultry comes in frozen form, I have a short video, a 2-minute video on frozen poultry that I'd like to share with your permission. So that's frozen is new fresh, that's what we call it. And very quickly, Sureshji, I'd like to touch upon the current protein deficiency in the country. As per a recent survey, more than 75% of the population is protein deficient, and over 90% don't know their daily protein requirement. So there is a need to bring in a protein-rich product. So our aim is to provide a protein-rich and hygienic option to our consumers.
Right.
And if we look at India, even though poultry is one of the most popular meats in the country, the per capita consumption remains less than 4 kilograms, whereas the ICMR, which is the Indian Council of Medical Research, recommends about 10.5 kilograms. World average is somewhere around 17 kilograms. So there is this huge gap. So what we are doing is that we are sort of working towards making India protein sufficient.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. I think your your presentation definitely was very tempting. It'll get many people to have US chickens, I'm sure. But I hope you have got enough supplies. You have taken care of your supply side of your business?
Absolutely. Initially, with the COVID, there was some lag in the port clearances due to, you know, pile-ups, even though custom clearances were a 24-hour essential service.
Right.
Due to the transportation issues, there was some lag, but now things have normalized slowly.
So, in all the big cities, at least you get frozen chicken?
Absolutely.
Okay. Any particular stores?
So, it's available across.
Okay.
You can go to any store and you'll be able to find in the frozen category, whichever store.
Fantastic. Okay. Okay. So, right. That brings us to our next speaker. Mr. Harish Lunani, Director, Soumitra International. Mr. Harish Lunani.
Good morning, Sourishji.
Good morning. Good morning.
So I'm sharing my screen now.
Absolutely.
Can you see the screen?
Yeah, I can see it.
Great.
Viewers?
Yeah. So I'm representing Soumitra International from Jodhpur and Aligarh. Namaste to IIT family. Last year we have participated in the exhibition for the first market. And this is welcome to your virtual showcase. Thank you all for staying home and staying safe and being here for the webinar. We are manufacturers, exporter, and designer, Mr. Soumitra Maheshwari, of industrial, vintage, handcrafted furniture, lighting, decor, and for endless unique products for hospitality, retail, and workspaces. So we have resorts, restaurants, cafes, breweries, and we are majorly into exports. And since last 3 years, we started focusing on Indian market, supplying to our customers in India, where we thought we should also increase our business in India apart from exports. We are currently exporting to US, Canada, Spain, France, South Korea, Australia, and small countries like Papua New Guinea. So we majorly deal with leather, iron, cast iron, and glass, marble. So we have been innovating. We have been replicating. So last 2 years back, we have received a very interesting project where Chinese companies have closed down because of pollution issues. China government has gone very strict on pollution norms. So our UK partner has sent us samples to replicate. And there is no shame in replicating, because once you know how to replicate, then only you can innovate. So that's how we are seeing the market, where if people are unwilling to buy from China, India can replicate and then innovate. The first step is replicating, knowing how to do it, and you can innovate.
No, so Harish, yeah. Sorry to butt in, but you know, one thing which China always has an advantage in is this price factor. You know, Chinese products are always cheaper than products from anywhere in the world. How price competitive are you?
We've been to China 2 years back, looking after the furniture.
Sorry, there's some computer audio problem.
And the pricing. Yeah. So, is this clear now?
Now it's clear, yeah.
Yeah. So, I was saying we've been to China and we participated as a customer and tried to understand the pricing. And we found ourselves cheaper than what China is doing. Then we built in confidence that this is a time where if we have scale and we innovate, then definitely we can beat the pricing that China have.
Right.
There are two ways to do it. That is like be a manufacturer also and be a trader also, where you see things and you can do things. If you're not able to do, at least you can trade.
Right. That's right. I think that's very important. So, your big takeaway from your session is that we have products of the caliber of what is being produced in China, and maybe right. better because they're innovating continuously. And that is, so we have alternatives to made in China very much in our backyard, you know, not very right. far away from Delhi, from Jodhpur in Aligarh. Okay.
You can see my.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah. Okay. Now you can be heard. Yeah.
Can you see my screen?
I can see you, but if you're making a presentation, I can't see you.
Okay. One second. Get back to my presentation. Can you see it now?
Now I can see it. Yes.
So this is not about China and something. This topic which is going on now. So that word has come up.
Right.
Otherwise, India has a lot of handicraft where Indians are innovating any help from other parties. And then the customers from foreign nations are depending on Indian designs.
Right.
China has been a copying hub rather than innovating. Then now at this stage, they are innovating.
That's right. I think that is the big takeaway, no? Innovative right. products are available from the neighborhood. You don't have to look far. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Harish, so much. And we will now move to our next speaker, Mr. Abhinav Arya, Director Planning, Fabcare Garments and Textile Machinery. Mr. Abhinav Arya, where are you?
So very good afternoon.
Good afternoon, yes.
Everyone, and yes. Thank you so much, IHE, for giving us this opportunity at this time that we can showcase, we can tell the world that what exactly we are doing in terms of fighting with COVID-19. So there are a few things what Fabcare is doing in terms of hospitality linen washing, which is the most crucial thing. And yes. I can say that it's time to relook at infection control practices for hospitality linen, which is sidelined or not much focused till date.
Right.
So today's presentation is all about that, how we are able to counter that and how we are fighting against COVID-19, especially when the linen, when the bath linen is quite crucial whenever our guest comes into our hotel. So it's our, priority as well as responsibility towards our customer coming in, that they are getting, a virus-free or a bacteria-free kind of a laundry.
That's right.
So just to brief everyone that what exactly we are doing and what we are. Fabcare is basically into complete laundry and dry cleaning solution. We are manufacturers, and we are India's largest manufacturers when it comes to laundry and dry cleaning equipments for hotels and hospitality, plus
right.
healthcare sector. Mm-hmm. So just to showcase that our manufacturing base is in Mundika, and we have our second unit at Manasar, and the third one coming up in a big way at Reliance Mat. So this is our Mundika unit, this is our Manasar unit, what we have. And this is the upcoming unit, which will be India's biggest one, single right. floor. And at the same time, we are going to have a tie-up with an American company, so that whatever equipment any of our hospitality or our healthcare sector is buying from outside because of some policies laid down by management companies, so they can buy it from us directly. So there is no point going outside and spending dollars on that.
Right.
So,
right.
What we have done a tie-up with a lot of companies in and around the world. Since we are manufacturers, so we have chosen the best equipment which is available around the world. We are representing Alliance Laundry, which is world's largest manufacturers of industrial laundry and finishing equipment. Like, we are representing Primus and Speed Queen. For finishing equipment, we are representing Pony. For dry cleaning, we are representing Mastrelli and the few chemicals and dosing system what we are doing. So as far as our knowledge in terms of fiber, thread and fabrics are concerned, so we are directly related to, right from fiber to to the garmenting side. Apart from dealing with these hotels, like Meridian is there, Radisson is there, Taj is there, Marriott is there. So they have started buying Indian equipments also lately. So these are the government organizations with whom we are associated with. These are some premium brands what our garment exporters are making. So as far as the, you know, designers are concerned, as far as the garments are concerned, linen is concerned. So we are attached to a lot of players in India who are exporting as well as supplying to hotel industry. So when we come to the COVID situation, the basic thing what we need to look for is the potential winners and the losers in this COVID situation. When it comes to hygiene and cleaning, you can see that a personal and healthcare has been on top three categories. So we are considering as a, you know, major boon, especially for the garment washing, linen washing. So after post-COVID, you can see the laundry will look like this. People wearing PPEs, you need to create something that the infection should not carry for your workers towards your clients who are coming in. This is something, this is Redison View, the yesterday picture that you can see that people are totally into PPE and doing the washing thing. You have to take care all the linen and garment in a water soluble bags. It should not be exposed. It should come in like this, and you need to directly feed in the washers. For the guest laundries, you need to get net bags for the retail segment. So you need a polyester bag. You need a net bag so that it should not be exposed immediately whenever you open it. You need to first dry it at least for 10 minutes so that the surface disinfection should happen. After that, you can sterilize it during the wash cycle or the dry cleaning cycle. This is something new what we are going to offer everyone. Earlier, it used to be only with the healthcare segment that the barrier washer were taken into consideration dealing with the healthcare segment. But I think that the way COVID is spreading, and I think we have to live with it for the next 1 year, 1.5 years, 2 years. I don't know how much time will it take to take care of things, how much time people will take to adjust with the things. So this is the solution what we have for the hospitality. And for the upcoming project, we would recommend that they should be going ahead with this. How does it work? There is a small video which will make everyone understand that how does it work and why it is so important.
Statistics show that from 10 to 15% of nosocomial infections, which lead to an average of 5 extra days in hospital, and in extreme cases, to the death of the patient, are due to unsatisfactory linen hygiene. Elderly people and children are more at risk to infection due to their less efficient immune systems. Studies all over the world indicate that linen is a major factor for the transfer of infections and superbugs. Operators in laundries must have total care management to maintain a high level of hygiene in their production to ensure that linen is free of certain bacteria, for example, Staphylococcus aureus, Salmonella, Listeria, and so on. This is such an important subject that Primus has decided to become a partner with two microbiological institutes and test under real conditions the recontamination risks that apply to the laundry. These tests were carried out in a laundry using Primus hygienic barrier washers where the soiled and clean linen are separated by a physical barrier. The potential, therefore, for contaminated linen to pass into the clean environment is eliminated. The barrier concept requires positive air pressure on the clean side and negative air pressure on the soiled side of the laundry to avoid cross-contamination of the linen after the washing process. The methodology used was in accordance with the EN14065 ISO norm, focusing on laundry process textiles and the biocontamination control system. Primus has developed a full range of barrier
So this is something what all the hospitals should look into.
I think this is very useful. This is very useful.
Yes, because this is something what everyone has to look for, because it spreads through the air, and to control everything, you need to have a barrier given on that. So along with that, we also do a lot of packing things and transportation equipments. Plus, we do a lot of designing part, that how your laundry will look like when you will, finalize the equipments and all.
So right.
This is something what we keep on learning through our counterparts, through the experience of our customers. So this is what we are offering right now for COVID, which is very useful and as per WHO and European and American norms.
Right.
So absolutely. Thank you so much for the time. Thank you so much, Luigi.
Thank you so much. This is very useful, I think. Very, I was wondering if you could leave the, you could email your presentation to my colleague Radhika Arora. I think she has been in touch with you already. A lot of these things we can then put up for our audience. The audience, by the way, has many specific questions, but those questions we'll pass on to the persons they've asked to. Please help us by sending your answers as soon as possible. Okay, because there are very specific questions. Shall we? Abhinav, your screen has frozen.
I'll do that. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, now that's all right. Okay. Thank you so much. As I was saying, there are a lot of questions which are very specific to the particular presenters. So we will pass those questions on to the presenters concerned. Please make sure that the replies come back as soon as possible. We will then, circulate these answers to our entire database. By the way, as you know, that this event is not only being not only on Facebook Live, but it is also going to be recorded and put on YouTube. So this has a much longer shelf life than you think it is. I now invite Mr. Mohit Agarwal, Sales Director, South Asia, Warwick Fabrics. Mr. Agarwal.
Thank you, Sureshji, a very good afternoon to everybody down here. Radhika, can you just put on the presentation, please? What I've done is that I have broken my presentation basically into two areas. One is I'll be talking about the company, a small bit about the company, and then what we have to offer from Warwick post, like in the era of COVID. Radhika, can you just put it on the full slide, please? Okay, fair enough. So just to let you know that Warwick Fabrics is an Australian company with about more than 53 years of history. We started off in Melbourne, Australia. And as of now, we have got 12 showrooms all across the 12 cities of Australia. Then we have got an office in Auckland that takes care of the New Zealand office, New Zealand. Then we have got an office in India, that is Delhi, wherein we have our warehouse, which I head, and this particular office takes care of the South Asia operations. Then we have got an office in Dubai that takes care of Middle East, and then an office in London that takes care of entire of Europe. Radhika, next slide, please. Just to give you a brief about what Warwick Fabric is, it's as I mentioned, it's more than a 50-year-old company. We have got five factories spread across the world. Two in Australia and then the balance three in various parts of the world. We stock more than 1.5 million meters of fabrics at all times. That is around 15 lakh meters of fabric at our main warehouse, which is in Melbourne. And the size of this particular warehouse is approximately of the size of a football field. Our company would be approximately as a group about 100 million. And then we offer to the market approximately more than 1,000 designs, which covers planes, textures. That's slightly technical, but that's the form of patterns that we offer. Radhika, next slide, please. This is the product offering that we have. In fact, we offer a full bouquet to the people in the industry. We offer textures, planes, leathers, prints, leatherites, even outdoor fabrics used near the pools and the awnings, and even the floral jacquards. Radhika, next slide. basically the what, how do we differentiate ourselves with the other companies that exist in and around India is that we offer certain finishes that we offer on a fabric. One is that Halo Easy Clean property, that is in case something spills over it, you can eat it with a hanky or a tissue paper. Most of our fabrics are of a very high commercial grade with more than 40,000 Martindales or rubs that we call it. Most of our fabrics has got fire retardant properties. We have got, because we export to 52 countries, so we have got an international color palette, and probably we are the only company in soft furnishings which offers you a guarantee on the furnishing fabrics. Radhika, next slide. This is something, a small picture of our office and warehouse in New Delhi, Okhla, which we started in 1997. Before that, we used to import fabrics through an importer, but then we took charge of opening our own office, and we have got an office and a showroom with two warehouses wherein we stock more than 50,000 meters always in our two warehouses. Radhika, next slide. This is kind of customers that we cater to. We cater to the customers like the likes of Indian Railways, corporates like Stanley, Godrej, modern retail like Home Center. We cater to hospitality sector with the likes of hotels like Taj, Oberoi's, ITC, and then even multi-brand retail outlets like Jagdish Store, Bharat Furnishings, which keep a plethora of other brands also. Radhika, next slide. So this is now the second part of my presentation, what we have to offer in the era of COVID. So we are offering a range of fabrics which comes already with a treatment called as Health Guard. This is particularly a fabric or a leather which is antimicrobial, anti-dust. So in case anything sits on it like a bacteria on it, it repulses back. So how do we do it? What we do is that we pass this particular fabric in a tub with a chemical which forms a layer on the fiber, and then that is dried, and then that comes out. So this particular layer forms on the top of the fiber. So anything coming and hitting onto it is repulsed back. Second slide. Then there's a treatment that we do, which is called as an on-guard treatment. For the fabrics which don't come under the health guard, which is already treated, we can do a treatment on any of the fabrics. Like I mentioned, we have got more than 1,000 fabrics. So we can do the treatment on top of it, which is again antimicrobial and antibacterial. Next slide, Radhika. And then the last that we have to offer in the era of COVID is a Halo fabric, which is easy clean, easy. It is easily clean fabric. So something like a vine or a ketchup falls on it just with a hanky or with something like a cleaning tissue, it comes out. So these are the three options that we are offering in the era of COVID, which probably always existed in probably 3 years back, wherein we launched all these finishes in Middle East, because that is something which was basically asked by the designers and architects, but then this was never asked here in India. But when looking at the present situation, this is something which we are offering right away in case somebody has an inquiry or something, that we can always cater to with certain samples, specifications, and all these finishes that we do come with a certification as per the Australian standards, because as this, our company is an Australian company, so we have got all this certified of the particular finishes, and in case somebody needs it to be done by a local testing agency, we can always do that. The last slide, Radhika, and this is my contact details. So in case somebody is really looking at some information or some samples to be sent across, we can always do it. And especially this would be something which would be, these three finishes what I mentioned would be something which would be very good for the hospitality sector, especially wherein you have got, especially in the reception areas or in the restaurants wherein there's a high inflow of customers. I'm not very sure in terms of when will the restaurants and the bars and restaurants in the hospitality sector will start, but we can always start looking at it as of now once things have started opening up. Sureshji, this is what I had to present. Yes, Sureshji, I'm done with my presentation. Anything that you want to ask me?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, it's better. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. Now, someone asked, you know, how long does this, the disinfectant guard that you're talking about, the head guard, how long does it stay? How many washes? After how many washes do these stay?
Yeah, see, on an average, if you're putting it on a furniture, you normally do a dry clean or a clean wash probably once in 5 months or 6 months. So this particular treatment would last for at least 2 years. So you're looking at a wash of at least 4 to 5 washes.
Right. Okay. So I think you've answered the question.
Yes.
Okay. Now, please again, let me request all the panelists to leave behind any presentations that you have. We will make sure these are circulated among all our attendees today, as well as to a bigger database. So please leave your presentations. We'll circulate them electronically. The next speaker today is Madan Gopal Mishra, the manager Kai Group. Mr. Mishra.
Hello.
Yeah. Okay. I can hear you. Yes.
Yes. So. First, I just introduce about Kai to all, and after that, I request to play that video, which is already there with IHE.
Right.
Am I audible to all? Is it clear?
Well, audible, but you're audible to me. I'm sure you're audible to all.
Yeah, it's okay.
Yeah.
So, as you know that I am Madan Gopal Mishra and I am representing Kai India, which is 100% subsidiary of Kai Group Japan. So Kai was founded in Seki City in Japan, known for its history of over 800 years as the home of forging blades. While passing down the skill and spirit which continue to flow in the land, we aim to expand our product lines focusing on the blade as well as related items. So
you're into making kitchen equipment, like cutlery and all.
We are into professional knives.
Oh, kitchen knives. Okay.
Kitchen knives. Professional knives.
That's it. Okay. Okay.
So I'm just briefing about Kai. Kai itself has more than 100 years of age, and the Kai company has been producing cutlery according to the tradition of the legendary samurai of old Japan. So. With the highest quality standard, Kai has made it its mission to produce special knives for daily use, made from natural resources, shaped and formed accordingly to the expertise of the ancient blacksmith art of the samurai group. So these all are based on samurai pattern. So Kai cooking knives is a epitomized Japanese craftsmanship carried out with the highest degree of precision. From the design to complete of each individual knife, the focus is on the development of integrated and carefully considered products. Since beginning as a family business in 1908 as Seki City and developed into an international company now. So nowhere else in the world can you find a cutlery related manufacturing which has developed close to 10,000 products in the cooking, grooming, beauty care, medical field. So
really, okay, you diversified into other areas too.
Yeah, we Kai is a synonym of, you can say, like edge. We are producing everything where is edge required, where is blade required, where is cutting required. We are into medical field, we are into garment field, we are into hospitality field, we are into personal care field. Like in personal care, we are manufacturing razors because edge is required there. We are developing, we are manufacturing equipment which is used by medical staff to operate any human something. Mm-hmm. There is edge also required. So we are into edges. So this is just a brief. And as I told, they are available worldwide. So Kai, they have three plant in Japan and a headquarter of the company there. And they have two plant in the US with a country office. They have two plants in China with an office. They have a plant in Germany with an office. They have a plant in France. They have a plant with one plant in Hong Kong. They have a plant in Vietnam. They have a plant in Korea. And also recently they have set up the plant in India with a corporate office in Gurugram itself in Gold Coast Road. And plant is in Japanese Industrial zone in Neemrana, Rajasthan. So from Monday, we are also started our production again, and we are planning to export products from here to other countries too. So that will be written of made in India products to the other countries. And apart from knives, we are also offering OEM manufacturing, private labeling services to customize corporate gifting options.
You know, how will all this, keeping in mind the requirements which will arise as a result of COVID-19, you know, are you doing anything specific concerning that?
We are planning to launch a UV stabilized box for knives and cutleries. So this is under production and under planning, I can say, because due to this COVID era, we all are staying at home. So we are doing Zoom meeting, Google meeting, and planning many things. So hopefully, finally, we'll launch very soon.
Because there'll be a lot of concern. For instance, you know, especially say the Japanese knives are particularly favored for the slicing fish, among other things, you know.
Yeah.
There'll be a lot of concerns about the, you know, whether any disease can be transmitted through knives also, you know. So I guess putting them in UV boxes should be a great help. You know?
Definitely. Disease are not transferred from knife. That is transferred due to carelessness of hygiene.
Bad hygiene practices.
So to take care of that, we are planning to launch a UV box. So that is better way to ensure the chef or the user to keep things clean.
That's right. Okay. Great. Thank you, Mr. Mishra.
One more thing I would like to
add. Yeah, okay. Sorry.
Knives, we are offering OEM manufacturing, private labeling. I just mentioned. We are also going to launch corporate gifting very soon in India also. So this is all about the brief introduction of KAI. And I want to tell my phone number and mail ID if anybody want. So
absolutely.
You can note it down and we can in touch after the this Zoom meeting.
You could put it in the chat room. You could put your phone number and email ID in the chat room.
Okay.
So that people see it. You know?
Sure. So I request to play that video on my behalf. Radhika.
Sure, sir. I'll play that.
I'm not connected. My number is Sami. Hello.
Meanwhile, I have few made in India professional knives at home. Color-coded knives for hospitality industries we are developing. These are very soon going to launch in India. And we are planning to export it to other countries.
Give me one.
Yeah, please. These are three colors I have it at home, but we have developed all the colors which is required in hospitality industries as per the government and international standards. Meanwhile, any of the person have any inquiry?
Mr. Mishra, sorry, I have to cut in. I have to move on to Mr. Vinay Mittal because he has to leave the webinar for an urgent meeting. I will move on to him. What we'll do after he completes his presentation, we'll give you half a minute, or 1 minute for you to play the corporate video.
There is some error. I will, in the meanwhile, fix it.
Oh, yeah, please fix it while... So, Mr. don't worry, we'll play a corporate video. Once the error is fixed, we'll come back to you, okay? Okay, thank you so much. I invite Mr. Vinay Mittal, Director, Deepali Designs and Exhibits, to make his presentation.
Yeah, hello everybody. My name is Vinay Mittal. I'm from Dipali Designs. So we were initially into business of events and exhibitions. So we were providing infrastructure for infrastructure and services for events and exhibitions all over India. So now, you know, since last 2 months, we have diversified into, you know, the Corona related protective equipments, the PPE kits and other related accessories. So I'll start quickly. I'll just first run a presentation, you know, a brief company video of what we have developed in the last 1.5 months. Hello. So these are the certifications, various certifications, CITRA, OFB, ISO, etc. The various types of fabrics. The various other products, nitrile gloves, three-layered masks, shoe covers, N95 masks, safety goggles, face shields, disposable bags, misting units, non-touch hand sanitizers, checkup rooms. The hand sanitizers, sodium hypochlorite disinfectant spray machines. So now we'll just take you through our works, our factories. So this is where all the fabric cutting for the PPE kits happen.
Mr. Mittal, what made you make this quick transition, you know?
Once this Corona happened, so I became quickly assured that, you know, for the next 1 year, I think at least 1 year, you know, we won't be having any exhibition and event business. So overnight and finally we are, you know, habitual of transforming things overnight. So that practice of transforming things, you know, overnight gave me the confidence that we could also overnight turn around a business. And finally,
amazing.
So I'll take you through all the facilities. We've invested a lot of money and we are supplying it to a lot of governments now. At present also, I'm in Lucknow at KGMU, King George's Medical University. And
right. We're
supplying to Uttar Pradesh Medical. Aman, you can continue with the video. Don't pause it. So Uttar Pradesh Medical Supply Corporation and you know, other various government and private entities. Also, we've launched our own website, DipaliProducts.com. We are getting good potential orders on our websites also. Further, once we finish this video or the company video, I'll also take you through the various range of products. So here is where the pattern of the fabrics are cut.
Right.
So whatever the pattern designs are, we do around our main tailor masters, they cut all the patterns.
So this the machinery and all you had already in place, or did you get them?
We got in people with domain knowledge, put in the new machinery, everything. Yeah. So I told you, we invested a lot of money.
And record time, you know.
Yes. In 1 month, you know, we have been able to turn around and we are manufacturing, I mean, very high quality products, very, very high quality products.
Mm-hmm.
I'll also show you later. So, you know,
and I think a lot of your PPE kits will be required by the hospitality industry.
I'll come to that later in the presentation, what I have for hospitality industry. So, you know, not only we are working on the product, we are also working on the strategy on to consult people as to, you know, what type of PPEs are required for different type of people in different industries. So if I take hospitality industry, what a guard would be required to wear since he's outside in the heat,
Right.
What kind of a PP? This is a hot tape seam sealing machine. So you know what happens when we stitch a fabric? So there is a penetration of virus through the seam. So now here we have a hot tape seam sealing machine, which seals the seam, which makes it totally protective to virus. Now all these fabrics that we are using, they're already synthetic blood penetration tested. So synthetic blood penetration is a mechanism by which you check that at a particular pressure, whether synthetic blood is penetrating through the seam of the fabric or not. This is our in-house lab. So we have got our own in-house lab. Right. We do a lot and batch testing of the material and then supply it. Because where we are supplying it, high stringent requirement is there of quality. You know, so all these lab setups that you see is for testing the blood penetration. And we have got certifications from all the main agencies like CITRA, Ordnance Factory Boards, you know, the GMP certificates, the ISO certificates for all our products. Okay, so now I'll just quickly, since we are short of time, I'll quickly now take you through a product brochure.
Mm-hmm.
So we have developed, at present, we are continuously developing new products. So now, this is a breathable tri-laminated fabric. Now, you know, since it's a webinar, so now there are 3-4 things that distinguish each fabric from each other. So some are breathable, some are non-breathable. Okay, some are reusable and disposable, biodegradable. Okay, and some are reusable and washable. Abhinav, I had met him around 15 years back when we used to do garment technology. I don't know whether he can recall me. Hello. Yeah. So when I was going through his range of laundry equipment, so it made me very positive how we could, you know, link up with him to see that what kind of our fabrics could be washed in his machines for reusing. So now this is a SSMMS non-woven fabric. So Aman, can you just take it back? Aman, can you take it back? Yeah. So SSMMS non-woven fabric. Now this is a Aman, just pause. Yeah. So SSMS is a spun bond fabric. So it has got a very high breathability and besides that, it is a very good virus protection fabric. So it has got a good good resistance to synthetic blood at 20 kPa, which is a very high value. So it is very good for controlling the virus. But this is a little costly fabric. Next, Aman, can you go to the next one? So these are non-wovens which are mainly in use. Now non-woven fabrics have to be laminated, so they become non-breathable. So they are very low on pricing, but the problem is that they are not breathable. So people who are not in an air-conditioned environment, you know, they may have a little problem because it becomes very hot in it. So therefore, what I was saying was that for different people in different industries, we require different garments. So for example, a guard sitting outside cannot wear a non-woven laminated fabric. He would perhaps need some kind of a breathable fabric. Also, you know, we have to see that each person, how are they interacting with each other? So I don't see a guard really coming too close to the general public. Okay. So maybe, then we could suggest that only his hands or his face is covered. Okay. And for example, waiters who are constantly totally in touch with public and public are in touch with them. So for them, you know, it could be that the whole body is covered. So for different segments of people, what part should be covered? What fabric should be there? Keeping in mind budget, their designations, you know, where they're operating, in which environment they're operating. So the whole consultancy will give to each hospitality sector. You know, it's a 5-star hotel or a restaurant.
Mm-hmm. Hello, is there an audio problem? Tushar, is there an audio problem?
Hello. So on the behalf of Mr. Vinay Mittal, I'm Aman. So I can continue this next presentation.
Okay, but you've run out of time.
Yes. So
it's going to be quite late, you know.
Yes, so just give me 1 minute. So the next presentation where we can be used, like.
Yeah, I'm back online.
Because we have overshot the time limit. But if you have any concluding thoughts, any concluding statement to make,
please do it. That's it. As I showed you, just open the restaurant one. Aman just opened. I'll just take 1 more minute.
Please.
We have developed 6 ranges of fabrics, and then we are developing separate videos for separate sectors to showcase as to what people are involved at what levels, what type of protective equipment they could wear. So now we will just be contacting all the different hospitality chains and working with them to see how we can provide them different solutions for people at different levels with different budget levels and fee kits. I've concluded, so we can end it here.
Thank you, Mr. Mittal. I think this was much needed, a presentation like this, because we keep hearing about PPE kits, but it's interesting to see that it's available now in our own city, very near us.
Not only available, many variants of it.
Many variants of it. Great.
Suiting, as per the people involved.
Thank you so much, Mr. Mittal. We will, Mr. Madan Gopal Mishra will come back to you. Or do you have your presentation ready?
No, Aman has got it. He can send it to you. Aman, can you send it to
me? Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Please send it to my colleague Radhika Arora or Tushar Gupta.
Okay.
We will make sure that these presentations go out to our audience.
Sir. Okay, sir.
Right, sir.
Thank you so much again. Mr. Mishra, it's your... is your film ready?
Thank you. Radhika, please play that video for everyone.
Can we then move to
Mishra? If you could take the next speaker, Mishra, I will have to come back. I don't know why it is not catching.
Okay, don't worry, Mr. Mishra. We will not go without seeing your move, film.
Thank you.
Mr. Bhatnagar, thank you for your patience. You were here at another webinar, and you made so many valuable comments then. The webinar is all yours. Please present your product.
Thank you very much, Mr. Bhattacharya. Good afternoon to everybody, and thank you, IHE, for giving us this opportunity of presenting what we do. We are a furniture company which is based out of Gurgaon. I'm giving you a small presentation which shows of
I think the lights came into the picture, but now they're out.
Can you see the presentation?
Who's handling it? Radhika, are you handling it?
No, I was handling it myself.
Okay, but we can't see your presentation.
You can't, just give me a minute.
So, do you need any help?
No. I'll just come in a minute.
Ah, there is it.
Yeah.
Yep. Done.
Okay. So, our company is called Multi Seats. We are essentially into manufacturing a lot of soft seating in India. We have, plant in a manufacturing unit in Gurgaon and one in Bangalore. So the factory is in the initial stages. We have a 20,000 square feet factory at one location, another 10,000 square feet factory at another location in Bangalore. So what we essentially have tried to move in here is to move away from all the imports that we were doing, and especially try to, you know, make whatever we were importing from China, we have totally replicated here by doing injection molding lounge chairs, doing a lot of sofas, doing a lot of woodwork in India. And we have been out of 100% import oriented company, we have become self-reliant on almost 80% of the products that we give for our clients, which have been a lot of corporates, as you see, and some of the hospitality industry, people like Holiday Inn, people like Barista, who we've been supplying regularly.
I saw Hyatt also.
Yeah, Hyatt also is there. Then ITC is there, Meridian is there, and Yum Restaurants and Cinnabon is there. So these are some of the hospitality industry that we have been working with regularly. And apart from that, in the corporate sector, we've been working with the who's who of, you know, the corporate sector totally. we are showcasing some of the products that we are doing in-house here. I'll give you pictures of the projects that we have already done, which may or may not be hospitality, but gives you an idea of what can be done in-house. So these are some of the products that we are making in-house. Some of the food courts that we have done.
What about anti-COVID or antimicrobial protective surfaces?
Anti-COVID and antimicrobial surfaces are, I think there's still a lot of work happening on that. Okay. As Mohit had put it, we are using a lot of Warwick fabric, which is... Okay. Still antibacterial. There is nothing which is
right there,
which is for antivirus.
Virus, but, yeah.
As a lot of research has gone in, a lot of things have gone in, fabric as such does not, you know, hold good for the virus. Virus is something which breathes in a way, needs a host. Needs a live host to get multiply further. Now, fabrics, especially since they are woven fabrics, they have certain pores. The virus goes into the pores and virtually dies down in a matter of small time. Unlike harder surfaces like plastic or metal,
or glass,
it stays for a longer time. But in fabrics, it virtually dies off very, very soon. So we are using a lot of fabrics which are you know, the woven fabrics from Warwick and other people. Essentially trying, we are going to show you a little small presentation ahead which shows how, you know, the social distancing can be done in the hospitality industry. So this is a little presentation that we have done. Now, because the number of people, number of guests, number of people who are going to be visiting are initially going to be low. So we've shown how in a waiting area, you can put individual seats separated by small tables and planters and things like that, which will keep the social distancing required norms. So this is one of the slides. If you can see, we've tried to keep a distance of 2 meters approximately. We are suggesting single seat sofas as far as possible. this is what has to be done. As far as the furniture is concerned, there is nothing really which has been developed except we are developing screens. to which can be provided in restaurants to, you know, separate out people. Screens which right. are made out of screens which are made out of
plexiglass,
fabric which are made out of acrylic, so that you know, the whatever distancing is not possible, you are at least separated out by screens. Now these screens are also acoustic screens, and will give you some kind of satisfaction that you are, if somebody is coughing, that cough is not coming directly onto you, it gets separated by a screen. So the hospitality industry is, in terms of furniture, still a lot has to be done, thought of, as to how you are going to work out on the social distancing norms. Apart from separating out people by the distance, we are using, trying to use a lot of wood. As I had said in my last this thing, that wood is something which is got properties which, you know, which has got a lignin fiber, which does not, you know, help in the growth of the virus or bacteria.
That's the point you made last time too. No?
Right. Some of the products that we are making, which are apart from, you know, the tables made out of wood and steel, the lounge chairs, the dining chairs, the bar stools, they are all very clean line furniture, so that, you know, there are not too many crevices where the bacteria or the virus can go and hide inside. So this is what we are suggesting now. Two-seater sofas will be you know, people sit too close to each other. So the norms will be longer sofas where people can sit at two different ends. This is something for an entrance lobby, individual chairs or longer sofas. Or if you see, these are high sofas where you are partitioned out. This is something that we are suggesting for the lounge areas. A lot of different models of places are being worked out. And, you know, not letting people sit facing each other. They'll probably be sitting at different angles, etc. So this is what we are thinking of. These are the screens that we are developing. If you see here, where my cursor is moving, these are screens dividing spaces. All we've been able to do so far. And if anybody would be interested in more detail, Radhika already has this presentation and can be given to them.
Great. Thank you so much, Mr. Patnagar. I mean, it's interesting that how you're dealing with this whole physical distancing. I think your services will be much required in the days and months to come.
Yes.
Now we have two speakers left who have been very patiently listening to all of you. Please give them a patient hearing too. I invite Mr. Jatin Gutt, Director, Radha Krishna and Sons. Mr. Jatin Gutt.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, hello. And thank you for being so patiently with us all this while.
Okay. So, after this pandemic, we have come up with a lot of products which are, you know, helping us out in our daily life. So we have come up with certain stands for the sanitizing. Then we have come up with thermometers, PPE kits, and a lot more products are involved in our portfolio. So I would like to show you these products slowly.
Mr. Gutt, I just want to make one. What is your currently, before this COVID pandemic happened, what was your line of products?
So we are into kitchen equipments, pots and pans, knives. So in our portfolio, we have got more than 15,000 products. which are related to smallware. Then we are also into hygiene, guest room amenities. Then we are distributor for Johnson Diversey. So we do chemicals as well.
Right. Okay. So you're very much in the business of, protecting our health.
Yes.
Okay. Good. Okay. So Justin, please shoot. Yeah.
So let me start now. I'll just put my system here.
Yeah.
As you can see, this is a sanitizer
dispenser.
So that we have developed, and it's completely germ-free, powder-coated, and it's made by machines. We have done it through laser cuttings. And Corosafe is the brand what we have registered now. We are just waiting for the trademark to be done. So I'll show you the functioning.
Mm-hmm.
प्रेशर पैडल को प्रेस तो हाथ आ गया
ओके सो इट इज पैडल ऑपरेटेड
या इट्स पैडल ऑपरेटेड दिस वी हैव मेड थ्रू लेजर कटिंग मशीन एंड प्रोबेबली So we are seeking, some of the MNCs where we'll be supplying this. And right. cost factor, we have, the requirement is in bulk. So we have kept a very minimum markup on it. And right. costing would come around 2,000 rupees per unit. So it's good right. for the receiving area, it's good for the lobby area. As you can see, the look. And then apart from this, for the entrance of the hotel or a restaurant.
Right.
This is what we have brought now. It's a wall-mounted thermometer.
Right.
So you can put in the log. It's all rechargeable. Can be put at the entrance. So there you are saving your labor. Like nowadays, you see, you go into any office, security officer, guards, everybody is checking with their hand, which is not at all safe. So this is something you can put into the wall.
Right.
Maybe two as per the standard heights. And then you can take the temperature automatically and all the temperature will get feed into it.
Right.
So you can just log into it and then later on you can see. So it has got a switch here through which you can turn it on, turn it off.
Right.
That's how it works.
Right.
And then apart from this, we have developed the PPE kits for the hotel.
Right.
So it's... It is available in 60 GSM, 70 GSM, 90 GSM.
So, in fact,
for this also, I've seen nowadays, people are saying that because of the certificate, the pricing is high or anything like that. But somehow we managed to have the certificates within the price of ordinary.
Okay.
Not only the kits. But we have got the gowns available from 200 rupees to 300 rupees range, which anybody can buy. They are one use. And then apart from this, we have got the gowns in rain cheater material also, which are 100% water safe. And can be you can sterilize them in any of the sterilization box. So that also we are developing probably within the next week. We'll be having one where, the dimensions would be around 14 inches by 14 inches.
Right.
So you can use it as per your convenience and according.
Right.
Then we have got UV chamber for the money, which can be used at the cash counters.
Right.
So it's a very small device and cashier can keep it along with him and can utilize it. And I'll show you that as well.
Right. Okay. Right. Okay. So even Mali gets disinfected, huh? Right. Jatin, please switch on your unmute yourself. Yeah.
Yeah. So apart from that, we have got some small nano sprayers also with us.
Right.
So that right. can also be used, like if any staff is working on the table. So if any department is there, like purchase is there, anybody is there, so right. they can just keep it handy in their pocket and they can right. use it anytime. Even for that also, cost is like 250 rupees.
Right.
So which I think a hotel can buy at one go for their staff and they can just give it one unit each to them.
Right. I think
I'll also show you. So this is the device, that's how it works.
Oh wow, okay, right.
So one can, you know, I mean, they can sterilize their phones, their mouse, anything.
Right.
If things are handy, they can use it in their hands also. So okay. any normal sanitizer which is water-based can be used in it.
Right.
And soon we are coming up with complete range also.
Right.
If you allow, I can share the screen and I can show you. Just hold down.
Right.
Can you see it?
Yeah, we can see it. That's it, but maybe please make sure that it gets circulated among our audience.
Yeah, I'll put it on the Google Drive now I can share the link so anyone can download.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Please. So these are some of the small devices which can be, you know, very useful.
I think they're very nifty. They're also quite inexpensive. I think very good, you know.
So we have got this automatic sanitizer fogger machine.
Right.
Then apart from that, this foldable sterilization lamp can be used for money, can be used for your mask, for PPE kits, or for mobile phones. So it has got a UV light mechanism which helps you out, you know, for the disinfection. Then we have got these manual disinfectant sprayers. So for outdoor area, this can be used. In fact, hotel, they must be having in the horticulture department. They already using it. Then apart from that, these thermometers are there.
Right.
Then we have got these automatic soap dispenser, which are nowadays very much required.
Absolutely.
In public washrooms. So in hotels, we hardly see, because recently we observed that, you know, in order to avoid plastic, they started using glass bottles with the
pump. Yeah.
Which is again, you know, something of no use now.
Right.
Still, they need at least one or two units for their public areas.
Right.
And then these face shields are there. Then we have got 3-ply masks with melt-blown material. So they are quite good. And it's made out of 25 GSM each layer. Then we have got these reusable masks. Right. And, you know, then we have got the disposable biohazardous bag. They are available in all the colors.
Right. Okay, you know, Jatin, we'll have to bring your presentation to an end. We get a drift of what you have to offer. Please share this information. We will definitely, as you said, if you put it on Google Drive, that will be great, you know.
Yes.
In fact, all of today's information can go on a group Google Drive, which the group can share later.
Okay, I'll surely put it right now on the drive, and I'll share the link right away.
Yeah, please put your email address and mobile phone number on the chat room. That goes for all the panelists. Please put your email addresses and mobile phone numbers on the chat room.
Okay.
Thank you so much, Jatin.
Welcome.
Thank you for your patience and for the lovely presentation. Now, the last person who's all the way from, where is he now? I can't. Ah, there is Michael Bendick, all the way from Bangalore. who has been very patiently listening to us. So you get the prize for the patience. And why don't you start right away? You're from Williams Refrigeration. So the business of refrigeration is your business. So Michael, please unmute yourself and get shooting. You have to unmute yourself, Michael. Yeah, good. You're out.
Hi. Yeah. Hi. Good afternoon, everyone. This is Michael here from Williams Refrigeration, Bangalore. We actually, if everyone knows that we are actually a manufacturer of refrigerations, as well as we are also a company who actually makes and manufactures of stainless steel fabrications, which is an equivalent to a fabrication of Italian style. The second most important thing is that myself, I'm Michael Benedict. I'm the division head of Williams Professional, who take care of the complete sector of the projects of hotels, hospitals, corporates, as well as the resorts. Williams is actually well known from a longer period into refrigeration. And now Williams is also will be known for a complete turnkey project. As it was COVID-19, we had done multiple workouts to come across the Indian market in terms of cost saving, in terms of the project which is coming up, where we could give our assistance as a manufacturing of Williams in India, as well as, if you know, in all over the world at the moment, it's a very time and the market is quite tough, as well as the expenditure in the market would be very less. In terms of business, what Williams look forward for is to guide our Indian market in terms of manufacturing of complete equipments, that is into a stainless steel, as well as is Williams have come up with products which will be coming across shortly, and as well as it will be going lively as well with a warm innovation with multiple consultants as well. So it's a quite a big surprise which is going to come up in Indian market, as well as Williams has come up with a multiple product, I would say. And we also have come across for people, factories which are open up for at the moment, as well as for the schools which will be opening up in further, where I have that data sheet I will be sharing across at the end. But where in this case also, I'll be having some of the videos also which will be shared across, which as it's a quite big and huge file, I would like to share it with each particular people so that they can go through it by individually or on basis on what Williams has come across and what they are going to look forward for the Indian market.
Great. So, you know, anything specifically on COVID, anything antimicrobial, any
We actually, I would like to share my screen with two products which we actually created for the company who are actually into manufacturing, as well as the companies who are like a trading companies in the local, as well as to operate the business sector of our Indian market, as where I would share the scheme, which has been actually a cost consuming, which we have done. Okay. And it will be very useful as for the people out in the manufacturing field. Allow me a moment.
Well, let me ask Radhika.
Can you see my screen?
Yeah, it's absolutely clear. Absolutely yeah. Clear.
So this is actually which we have created for a bulk, which as I mentioned earlier, we have created something for the industrial purpose, as who is going to help us to build our revenues for the in terms of having business in the market. This stainless steel, which you can see across on the screen at the moment, is actually is the first important part is for the safety, for the hygiene. Third important part is keeping the distance, where it is the most important role which has been played in our manufacturing field, as well as to in terms of any other manufacturing field, let it be into stainless steel, let it be into fabrics, let it be into furnitures, let it be into interiors, let it be into constructions, or let it be into MEPs. So in terms of what we have done is we have created this a particular product where we manufacture it by our own self, as well as we have done a cost resumption where we can save plenty of money on when you purchase such kind of particular product from Williams.
Okay.
As great. Well as,
yeah.
We have something, second thing, if you could just see the second one.
Yeah.
Is it visible for you?
No. I can only see this stainless steel hand washing system.
Just a moment.
And these are pedal operated.
That's correct. It's pedal operated, as well as it has the optional of using the soap dispenser, which is just next to it. And as well as it has a draining system, which has also been converted into, you know, if you see the grease trap system, which we have created that as well for the safety purpose. This is something which we have created for the factory people all across, where you can, it's quite cost consuming, as well as it is very safety, as well as it gives you a hygiene purpose for your field. It's actually all pedal operated, where as you know, in factory basis, everything is factory workers are quite different in on an operation base. So this is something which we had made it in an industrial style. If you could just see the design, which is out, it's quite different in terms of others. You know, the leg operated is just one step. It just gives an accurate amount of the self standing which we have, the sanitizing system which is we have created.
Right.
And as well as coming to as a complete kitchen manufacturer, I would like to say that we have come across with multiple trading products, okay, which we have newly joined and having a joint venture with them in future, which is coming up across in COVID-19, as well as to have the Indian market in business. We have companies like Rational, okay, as I would say that, which is giving a powerless in production of cooking lines.
Right.
Some of the major cooking lines which we are own manufacturing at the moment and in India, okay, as it's you are quite in the showroom at the moment, but I could share you the photographs and our catalogs as well, so you can go through it what we are actually into. And mostly everybody knows that it's Williams and Mr. Williams SR who's are actually the owner of the company, and we are quite reputed as a company in Indian market at the moment to utilize ourselves in terms of all the kitchen equipments what we do today.
Right. Okay, thank you so much. You know, I think this I see this pedal operated hand sanitizers and hand washing systems are going to be here to stay.
Absolutely. It's going to be for a longer period though.
COVID scare is over. Yeah, that's right. So many interesting products from terracotta plates to pedal operated hand sanitizers to UV chambers for coins, cutlery, crockery, so there are options and options available now. Of course, there are PPEs and wall thermometers, so many interesting things that are happening. The last, as I promised, Mr. Madan Gopal, do you have the presentation ready finally?
I will just play it.
Yeah, please. We have overshot the time limit by many, many minutes.
Screen is not visible, Radhika.
Can't see any.
Only voice is coming, but video is not.
Yeah, unfortunately, it's not moving. So, you know, but Mr. Mishra, I think we are running out of time. What I suggest, Radhika, is I guess you'll have to create a Google Drive with all this material. Is that okay?
Yeah, I will do that.
Yeah, and then maybe people can just access that drive and, you know, get more information about all the brands that were presented today.
Perfect.
Okay, great, fine. Thank you so much, Radhika. The team has been working.
Sorry, see, in the end, Mr. Rajesh Kumar ji also wanted to share a video.
Mr. Rajesh? Okay, Mr. Rajesh Kumar.
Hello, everyone.
From
Kumar Equipments.
Kumar.
Okay, sorry. Kumar Equipments. Yes, that's right.
Yes,
our
yes.
First speaker. That's
right. Yes.
Bole, please share your video.
So I just wanted to show some of the induction equipment that we were talking about in the earlier thing.
Right.
So I just allow me 2 minutes. I'll just show you. Can everybody see that?
Yeah, we can see it.
So as you can see that we have started the some of our R&D department for the inductions like 6 months back. So we have come up this kind of solution for the induction industry. So as you can see, there are automatic cookbooks. So it's an automatic rotating arm for the our clients so that they can easily work on it. There are some tilting boiling pans, some of the tilting type pans, boilers. This is the brad pan for our clients. Some of the stock pots. So the beauty of this that we are making in India, all the parts. So
right.
These are all customized for our Indian methodology, like how we use the equipment.
Right.
So we have designed it with all the passions. And let me tell you that all the stainless steel finish is SS304.
Complete
will be SS304. And it will be better for our industrial section, for our hospital sections. So we have a complete range of that. Also, for the COVID-19 situations, we have one other product which are into is in development section, but it's finalized yet. So let me just show you that also. This one, if you can see. Is this audible?
Mr. Kumar,
sorry, yes.
Yeah, this FSSAI and Ministry of Home Affairs, they seem to have a lot of reservations about these sanitization tunnels.
Yes, about the skin problems you're talking about?
Yeah, that's right.
The problem was that people were mixing a lot of alcohol and chemical section in that.
Okay.
So
right.
If you mix it with a water, chemical, and alcohol level, and there has to be in a proportionate.
Right.
It won't harm your skin and all.
Right.
About the main focus is that how much quantity you spray on that particular, which you
right.
Want. So it depends on that. So if
right.
You're sprinkling it more, so obviously that will be going to harming your body.
Right.
So there is certain level of alcohol, certain level of chemical and certain level of water should be involved, should be mixed with in such a way and should be sprinkled in such a way. So that's how you can do it.
I think that is something which is very important to remind people in the hospitality industry again and again. You know?
Agreed. So I'm just sending out a link in the message so that everybody can see that.
Yeah. And, you know, please share all this information with Tushar Gupta and Radhika Arora. They are people behind the show. They are doing a lot of hard work in putting this show together. So, please, you know. We'll have to bring this session to a close. Thank you so much for your very, very interesting presentations. I think you just opened up a new world for all of us. Thank you so much. Yeah, Mr. Mishra.
I have that video in my laptop. If you allow, so in all panelists.
I won't let you down. Tell me.
Okay, thank you.
I hope it's not long. Huh?
Yeah, it's just 1 or 2 minutes, I think.
Okay, tell me. Yeah, thank you. So that was those are really interesting. They look like sashimi knives. You know?
Yeah,
absolutely. Very good. Thank you so much.
Thanks, thanks to you.
Okay, and Hari Dasa ji.
उसकी
बेटी है ना दो बजे पे. हमें बातें बोलेंगे और उसके program. Please mute yourselves, Mr. Hari Dadu, who is the president of India International Hospitality Expo. I welcome him to give a vote of thanks.
धन्यवाद भट्टाचार्य साहब. आज हमारा ये जो वेबिनार है, ये 12th वेबिनार है हम जैसे कह सकते हैं. और लेकिन ये आज का वेबिनार बिल्कुल यूनिक है. आज हम इसमें अपने पैनलिस्ट में अपने जो एग्जीबिटर्स हैं वही सारे भाई हमारे मौजूद हैं और अपने प्रोडक्ट को शोकेस कर रहे हैं। मैं आईएचसी का प्रेजिडेंट जरूर हूं लेकिन आपके बीच का ही आदमी हूं। आपकी तरह मैं भी कुछ मैन्युफैक्चर करता हूं, पोल्ट्री बनाता हूं और आपकी तरह ही प्रोडक्ट को डिस्प्ले करता हूं, शोकेस करता हूं। लेकिन मैं आज बहुत खुश हूं कि हमारे आईएचसी में जो एग्जीबिटर्स हैं सभी इंटरनेशनली कम्पिटिटिव काम कर रहे हैं, प्राउडली अपना काम कर रहे हैं और भारत का नाम रोशन कर रहे हैं। मैं देख रहा हूं कि जो मैन्युफैक्चरर्स हैं वो इंटरनेशनली कंपटीशन में और इंटरनेशनल कंपनीज के साथ किसी भी तरह से पीछे नहीं है। हमारे बीच में कुमार इक्विपमेंट्स हैं, मिस्टर राजेश कुमार हैं, उन्होंने बताया कि वो जो मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कर रहे हैं तो लोकल इक्विपमेंट्स है, जो हमारे मोदी जी ने कहा लोकल कंपनी से ही इक्विपमेंट खुद के पार्ट्स लेकर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग करने का पूरा पूरा प्रयास कर रहे हैं। हमारे बीच में दीपाली डिजाइन से मिस्टर विनय मित्तल जी ने बताया और उन्होंने मुझे आश्चर्य कि उन्होंने ओवरनाइट अपनी इंडस्ट्री खड़ी कर दी पीपी किट बनाने के लिए और आज हिंदुस्तान में हम लगभग 450,000 पीपी किट पर डे सभी मैन्युफैक्चरर्स मिलकर बना रहे हैं, तो बड़ा हर्ष का विषय है। और यहाँ तक ये जो COVID-19 से परेशानियाँ हो रही हैं, मैं समझता हूँ हम सभी इससे जल्दी से छुटकारा ले लेंगे, अपनी हिम्मत से काम करेंगे। और अगर हम बात करते हैं अपने आईएचसी शो की, अगस्त में जो हमारा शो है ये थोड़ा सा डिफिकल्ट दिखाई दे रहा है कि हम इसको फिजिकली कर पाए, इसके लिए हम प्लानिंग कर रहे हैं इसको वर्चुअल फेयर के रूप में तैयारी करने की। और जल्दी हमारी एक जो बोर्ड है हमारा उसकी मीटिंग कर रहे हैं और वर्चुअल शो को हम इसको वर्चुअल फेयर में कन्वर्ट कर रहे हैं पूरे आईएचसी। अभी हम वही डेट में इसको शो को करेंगे जो हमारा 5-8 अगस्त का डेट था, उन्हीं डेट्स में शो करेंगे। और अगर फिजिकली शो की हम बात करते हैं तो थोड़ा सा इसको अक्टूबर में ले जाकर अगर पॉसिबल हुआ, मार्केट की डिमांड हुई, इंडस्ट्री की डिमांड हुई, तो इसको फिजिकल शो भी हम अक्टूबर में कर सकते हैं, ऐसा हम लोगों का अभी विचार है। जो भी चीज़ हमारी डिसाइड होंगी, जो हमारा एडवाइजरी बोर्ड डिसाइड करेगा, उस हिसाब से सबको अवगत करेंगे। लेकिन जो आज का जो हमारा वेबिनार का विषय रहा ये बड़ा एक्साइटिंग रहा, हम सब लोग अपने लोग सामने हमने बैठे हैं, दूसरी चीजें बता रहे हैं और जितने भी हमारे दूसरे व्यूअर्स हैं, ऑडियंस हैं, वो भी सब चीजें वो देख रहे हैं और बड़ा अच्छा महसूस हो रहा है। अभी इसी तरह से एक शो हम अपना 30 मई को एक शो ये जो अपना वर्चुअल शोकेस का है प्रोग्राम, एक प्रोग्राम और करेंगे। मेरा आग्रह है कि जो हमारे दूसरे एग्जीबिटर्स भाई हैं वो थोड़ा सा अपना कंपनी का प्रोफाइल हमें दें, बताएं, टीम को बताएं, ताकि हम उनको अपने साथ लेकर एक शो और कर सकें। अभी मैं इतना ही कहना चाहूंगा कि बहुत देर से सब लोग ये शो के अंदर, धन्यवाद।
धन्यवाद दादू जी, आज का बड़ा इंटरेस्टिंग रहा, वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग शो टुडे एंड लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू 30th मे। ऑल आर वेलकम, थैंक यू सो मच एंड थैंक यू फॉर बीइंग सच पेशेंट लिसनर्स एंड प्रेजेंटर्स। Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.